Good day. I'm Norman Wildberger, and today we're going to introduce the rational numbers. The first and most important example of what in mathematics is called a field, which is roughly a domain in which we can do addition, multiplication, subtraction, and division in a complete and consistent way. So the story up till now is that we've started with the natural numbers, and then we introduced the fractions by dividing, and we introduced the integers by subtracting. We want to now go from the integers to the rational numbers in just the same way as we went from the numbers to the fractions. That is, we want to augment the integers by allowing division. So let's just make sure we understand what these various terms mean. By num, I mean natural numbers. In Hindu Arabic notation, things like 1, 2, 3, and so on. By fraction, I mean an expression of the form 2 over 3, or 3 over 1, where the constituents are natural numbers. By integer, I mean an expression of the form 1 less 2, or 3 less 1, where again 1 and 2, 3 and 1 are natural numbers. What we're going to do is going to use these integers to form rational numbers. And a rational number is just going to be, just like this, an integer over another integer. Here's the official definition. A rational number is an ordered pair AB, where A and B are integers, and B is not equal to 0, and I'll explain that in a second. And we write this ordered pair AB as A over B, just the same way as we write a fraction. What is 0? 0 is a special integer. It's the integer 1 less 1, which is also equal to 2 less 2 or 3 less 3. So we require that the second natural number is not equal to 0 when we form this quotient. And there's an important notion of equality that you'll not be surprised at by now, that A over B is equal to C over D precisely when AD equals BC, when this times this equals this times this. So that's what a rational number is, and we illustrate that type by symbol RAT. That stands for rational number. Now let's introduce some notation that makes rational numbers look more familiar. So let's start with an integer. The integer 1 less 2, we'll write that in the more familiar way as minus 1. And we'll agree that 3 less 1 is written in the more familiar way, 2. Even though there is now a possibility of confusing integers with natural numbers, officially we want to keep them straight. More generally, if we have m less n, then there are three possibilities. If m is bigger than n, then this is equal to m minus n. We will write it as m minus n. If n is bigger than m, then we'll get what's usually called a negative number. We'll write it as minus n minus m. That's if n is bigger than m. And if m and n are equal, then we'll just use the symbol 0, as we've already introduced. Now a little bit of notation for rational numbers. 1 less 2 over 3 less 1. Now that we've got a name for 1 less 2, we're calling that minus 1. And 3 less 1, we're calling that 2. So this rational number can be expressed as minus 1 over 2. And we'll also introduce the other standard notation, that when we have 1 in the denominator, such as 3 over 1, then we'll abbreviate that to be a 3. We'll abbreviate 0 over 1 to be 0, 1 over 1 to be 1, and so on. That way the natural numbers fit inside the rational numbers, but it's a little bit of a deception, because officially rational numbers, natural numbers, integers are all separate types. Now we can define the main operations for rational numbers. First of all, addition. If we have A over B plus C over D, then we use exactly the familiar form for fractions. Sum is defined to be AD plus BC over BD. Here, A, B, C, and D are integers. The product A over B times C over D is by definition A times C over B times D. And then the inverse operations, subtraction and division, are easily obtained. A over B minus C over D is this expression, AD minus BC over BD. And A over B divided by C over D, which we also write A over B divided by C over D, that's equal to A times D over B times C. So those are the four main operations. And there's just a bit of qualification. In all of these, the denominators cannot be zero. And when we've divided here, we have to make sure that this C is not equal to zero, because otherwise we would be dividing by zero. So division by zero is not allowed, otherwise we're fine. All right, the rational numbers are now what is called a field. This is a technical term in mathematics. We want to be precise about what it means. So we'll say that the rational numbers, which is a type of object, together with the operations of addition and multiplication, form a field. And what does that mean? Well, it means that various laws are satisfied. First of all, the associative laws. P plus Q plus R equals P plus Q plus R. And P times Q times R equals P times Q times R. The commutative laws. P plus Q equals Q plus P. And P times Q equals Q times P. Then we have some special elements. Three special elements, in fact. Ones that were called 0, 1, and minus 1. And they have the following properties. That 0 plus P equals P. So we say that 0 is an additive identity. While 1 times P is P, that means for any P, that means that 1 is a multiplicative identity. And that 1 plus minus 1 together add up to 0. Then there's a further property called the inverse property, that if you have any element P which is not 0, then there should be another element Q, sometimes denoted P to the minus 1, which has the property that P times Q equals 1. So every element P has an inverse, when you multiply the two of them, you get 1. And finally, the distributive law that connects multiplication and addition, P times Q plus R equals P times Q plus P times R. And now it's an important exercise to verify that the rational numbers, together with the operations that we've defined, satisfy all of these laws. There's nothing really new in doing this, and I'm not going to do it because it would take me a few videos to do, but it's an excellent exercise for a graduate student or an undergraduate who's interested in understanding how mathematics really works. It's something that's often not done properly, but it's an important exercise. The rational numbers are the first example of a field, and later on we'll introduce other examples of a field. It's very important to recognize, though, that the rational numbers are the most important field. They always were, they always will be. People might try to convince you that the real numbers or the complex numbers or something else are more important. It's not the case. The rational numbers, which we've spent a fair amount of time developing, they are always the most important field in mathematics. Next time, we're going to have a look at how to visualize rational numbers. And we're going to connect rational numbers to remarkable objects called Ford circles. It's going to give us some really beautiful geometrical insight into the nature of rational numbers. I hope you're going to join me for that. I'm Norman Wildberger. Thanks for listening.